make any impressions on the lead.
And we're looking at the leader in the marathon, Yegorova of the Unified team. No one can... She hasn't looked over her shoulder, so she's obviously strong and she's obviously confident. And just in the distance there, behind that second car, we can see Aramori of Japan, who was fourth in the World Championships in Tokyo last year. But Yegorova looks strong. She's going to have to be strong, though, because the last part of this race is the most savage marathon course I've ever seen. We're just checking to see how far behind that group. Behind Yegorova is the chaser, but there's a group there behind Aramori, and it's Lorraine Muller of New Zealand, 37 years of age, and I don't think she'll mind me describing her as a veteran, but she's trained specifically for this race, this particular year. And then Vic Tagarova with a white cap on of the Unified team, just behind Lorraine Muller, and then Katrin Dorra, third in the last Olympic Games, and she's making a charge. And I think there'll be an awful lot happening in the last few miles. She wasn't very happy with that motorbike there, but she was desperately keen to get that drink on board, and I think that's essential. She's just drinking regular water. She's not got her own. Specific drink, and that's quite interesting.
Brendan, I saw that then. She's been fiddling in a pocket in her shorts. I think she took a tablet then.
Well, maybe it would be one of these electrolyte replacement tablets, and then you drink water with them, and it helps get the electrolytes flowing back through your system. I think there's going to be a dramatic finish in this marathon. Yegorova looking strong, making her bid for victory, but there's still 10 kilometers to go. You can see the pressure that the heat has caused. And then the stadium, the heptathlon, is continuing.